If you want to compete at the highest level, you have to have holdover birds. You have to have birds that are matured, not as individuals, but matured as a team. And they have to operate as a team. And that's the only way you're gonna compete. You know, they say if you have a dream and you don't have a plan, you know what that's called? That's called a wish.
If you were passing the champion,
right,
what would you do different this year if they were your birds?
Nothing.
Because
and
does he still have them, all those
yes,
birds?
Yes.
All 20?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. And if you look at Will Stenhouse has the same birds that competed last year. And keep in mind, he scored that score in half the time. So give him the full time, and he's going to be out there. So he's going to be catching him.
So we got a plan definitely over 300.
Yeah.
It's definitely going
to be yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely. We got some good stuff to look forward to. I'm excited about it. Now, you're flying.
Yes.
So, introduce yourself to the folks.
I'm Hutch, Kendall Hutchins. I go by Hutch.
So, Hutch, what is your prediction? What did you do differently this year, or what is your plan going forward?
As of today, since I just signed up today,
right,
I'm going to tighten up the reins.
Okay.
I've been flying 70 birds and 100 birds at a time,
right,
and stuff. So I'm gonna listen to some of these guys that pass the word. I'm gonna go home today. I'm gonna hopefully fly my birds in the individual kits, because basically what I do is, once what I did was let them trap in,
right,
on their kits.
Right.
Then I trap the doors, and that's what they fly with. Then when I let them up, they actually do kit really well.
Right.
But most of the time I fly them all together. So this year, I'm gonna make sure that I have select birds that are going straight over,
right,
and straight back into the kit.
Right.
And if I have any birds that are bumming, of course, changing my feet, because I think the last year I actually flew with 65.
Right.
The entire season, but in the high desert, so tricky. So I'm still trying to dial in on my feed.
So keep in mind, importance of those birds working as a team.
Yes.
So they gotta be together, they gotta work together, they have to know each other, they have to know who the lead bird is. So you gotta need time in with those birds working as a team.
Right now my one problem is still trying to find that one bird that has us on the wing.
Right. So, hello everybody. Thank you for joining us. This is another edition of the Roller Pigeon Evolution. I'm your host, Smitty, and my cameraman is Louis Quintero. Say hi to the folks, Louis.
Hi everybody.
So today we are here at the Royal Rumble Lawn Show. This is the first annual show, and we're gonna be talking to the guys that have registered to fly in this year's Royal Rumble. We just spoke to Hutch, and we got a bunch of guys coming, and stay tuned, and you're gonna hear what they've got to say.
How's it going? I'm Mark Booker, Ghost Town Roller Lofts, Outlaw Roller Club.
So Mark's been around a long time, knows his birds. I probably shouldn't say that, but he knows his birds. So what is your prediction this year? Or even better yet, what did you do last year that you did differently this year?
So last year I focused on breeding, getting more birds that were produce what I've had.
Right. Increasing your percentage.
Correct. Increasing my percentage, and then kind of doing more with less. Working, consolidating my family, working on a few solid pairs to push through to the next 5 years.
Right. So at this stage in the role, what are your birds doing? What are you seeing?
So last year I finished the season with a whopping 7 pigeons that were into the actual roll.
Uh-huh.
That's all I was able to salvage.
Right.
And so this year I'm looking at putting 2 of those away just to kind of push the family forward, working on the 5, breeding more, and it's a lot easier now because I'm retired.
Okay, awesome. So if you look at last year's front runners, you had Will Stenhouse, you had Happy, you had some guys that put up some decent scores, but not out of this world scores.
Right.
What do you think the score is going to range this year?
So, you know, I think it will be equivalent to, mm-hmm. and or I think it's gonna surge with the growth of the fly, right?
Right.
So you figure the more kits you fly, the more people flying, the more opportunity you have to score more points, you
right,
know?
Right.
And
right.
So I think we'll probably see an increase in flyers, of course, but then a higher point spread.
Okay.
Because
okay.
the guys that have done it, that are redoing it, they kind of have that mental slide of what it looked like last year,
right.
and their birds are older,
yeah.
so they're able to maybe do better.
Having mature birds is definitely going to be one of the things that's going to give some people the edge.
Yep, for sure.
All right, everybody, we're back, and we're doing an interview with Happy. Happy was last year's winner of the Royal Rumble. Happy, thanks for joining us.
No problem.
Now, so I've got some questions. So, obviously, you won last year. What are you doing differently this year to secure that win again?
Well, I'm tightening up my kid. You know what I'm saying? I lost like 180 some points due to two birds coming out kidding.
Right.
So my main focus now is tighten up my kidding so I can score every break that scores, you know what I'm saying, every break.
What are you seeing in your birds this year that you didn't see last year?
Nothing right now. I ain't flying right now.
Okay.
I ain't start flying now, but what I saw prior to lockdown was that I moved out those young birds that was causing me problems, you know what I'm saying, in the comp.
Uh-huh.
And now I'm just looking for birds, you know what I'm saying. If you're not kidding, I don't care how good you are, kidding is my number one issue this year.
Right.
Because I want to maximize every point I get. I can't do that if I got birds out.
Right. Excellent. So, who do you think is your number one competitor?
So right now, Will.
Will Stenhouse.
Will.
You heard it.
Will
that
Stenhouse
is the number one competitor right now. That's the guy to look for.
We have a lot of Art gonna fly. Well, Martinez gonna fly here. We gonna keep London Pole to fly. So
okay.
It's gonna be a competition.
You got Will. You got Art Martinez. You got Keith London. We got some strong competitors in the Southland. So this is gonna shape up to be an exciting season. We got more to come. Stay with us. Again, congratulations on last year's win.
Don't forget about the twin. They was impressive last year.
Okay.
They only can get better with their kids, so it ain't gonna be easy.
You gotta
really put in
the work,
the time, you know what I'm saying, to get the kid ready, because it got competitors this year. Everybody gonna be better this year.
Awesome.
But overriding thing is, I'm still gonna be number one again.
There you go. That's silent confidence. Let's get to the next one. Thank you.
There you go.
So again, we got some strong competitors in this year's competition. Right here, we got Marshall Duncan. If you don't know Marshall Duncan, you better get to know him, because Marshall Duncan has been doing it long, long time. Next to him, you got Arnold Jackson. Okay. Are you flying this year?
Yeah.
Okay. So just pan. This is who we got. Are you flying this year? Okay. So these three gentlemen bring a wealth of experience with them and knowledge that a lot of these young cats just don't have. So it should be really interesting. Really interesting. Now, you have birds flying right now?
Just starting to test the air.
Okay, Arnold. Okay. So one of the things I talked about, a lot of these guys are flying with birds that are not holdover birds that have not been tested at all. And what do you think? I mean, what are the odds when you've got guys that are flying with birds that are 2 years old versus the guys flying with birds that are this year's birds?
Well, you never know. I mean, I've seen some young kids, young active kids,
Right. But
it's hard to count on those type birds, you know.
Right.
Once you have an established old bird team, you know what they're gonna do.
Exactly. Arnold, what's your take on it?
No predators and we can do wonders.
Say that again?
No predators, we can do wonders.
No predators, we can do wonders. Yeah, that sounds like a wish. Because they're at my house.
That's right.
What do you think?
I'm the type. I mean, I always like older birds, holdover birds. You can't compete. You can't. I mean, there's always an exception. You're gonna have a good young hot team.
Right.
I prefer holdover birds any day.
Yeah.
Any of the major flyers all over the world, World Cup flyers, holdover birds.
Did you fly last year?
No.
You didn't. Okay.
No. Awesome. I was scheduled, but I had a big predator problem. I didn't have enough birds. I had 14. Couldn't even make the 15 mark.
So, who do you think? Well, Happy won last year. Who do you think are the guys to look out for, the guys that are going to be up in the top 10?
It just depends. I mean, but I would say the veteran Flyers have the advantage.
Okay.
I would say.
Definitely, definitely. Hey, thank you guys. Appreciate it. We got more interviews to come. These were just some of the guys that I wanted you to hear from, and we're going to have an exciting season this year, so stay tuned. Okay, so this is the show that I'm going to be judging today. So if you look at some of these birds, we got some really nice specimens. These are all young cocks.
Curry went, I had to go to the Uber. I walked in the ring.
I like the bird a lot. I like the way the bird is built, everything about it. But his condition is just poor right now. It looked like he just got off, maybe told me he just got off a baby. And in condition, I think this bird would have won it. First, second, third. Yeah.
All right. We got first, second, third.
Yeah.
I'm gonna write them down.
All right, first, second, third.
Yeah, but the blue. Priam wins? Yes. Oh, shit.
No, he killed it. Clean house.
He killed it. Like, he killed it.
Are these birds all the same birds, family?
The same, dad?
Yeah, are they the same family? I mean?
Yeah, they're the same.
Yeah, it shows. It shows because they're very consistent. This one is going to mature out to be better than this cock. He's a younger bird, but he's going to mature out to be better. I liked him. He's too immature. But this one right now has what this one will throw into. Good family bird.
Oh, what's your name, brother?
Juan Maldonado.
Good job.
Thanks.
Yeah, you see, and again, yeah, I'm thinking they're three different families, but I'm like, everything I just look at the family is right there with them. They're built exactly right. All their muscle is up here. They're wide across the chest.
Six nine five six. For water. Water feeder. Yeah, pick a water feeder. Wanna do one more? Let's do one more.
Four one.
A little mineral block. You want one of these mineral blocks. Yes, seven. Last four, six, seven.
They might have called my number.
Everybody won, Stanley.
I see you, Stan. How are you, man? Which one? Good. I don't know what you're asking.
That's 4-6-3-7-8. 6-3-7-8. 6-3-7-8.
I don't know what you're asking.
Right here.
Last four, 6-4-2-5. 6-4-2-5 for a bag of feed. 6-4-2-5, bag of feed. 6-4-2-5.
Hope y'all come to somebody line. That's early, guys. I knew what I was doing.
6-4-2-5, bag of feed. We're gonna do one more. We're gonna do some nesting pads. We're gonna do a whole pack, nesting pads. Yeah, pull one. You might pull your number. You might get lucky. We got $2
That's
tacos.
Muscle.
If you don't want a taco plate, we got $2 tacos or a $7 taco plate.
This hand is straight muscle. All
right, Skip. Pull.
That's muscle. She is muscle. That bird is straight muscle.
7068 Nestor Pass. 380-7068. You got that? 7068.
Another nice little hand.
7068. We gonna do two of them bowls. Tim, can you bring us the raffle tickets? Tim, blue tent, Tim.
Hey.
What we got? First, second, third. You write them down yet? You write them down?
Great muscle on this bird.
6938. 7449. Just like the bag of feet. Bag of feet. Bag of feet.
Condition's not great.
6731. 6731. 6731 for a bag of feet. 6731 for a bag of feet. Another bag of feed. 7204. Bag of feed. 7204. Got a little tone. 7204. Bag of feed. Another nesting pan, another nesting pan. Three eight zero six one five seven. What you want to give, Jeff? I'm going to let Jeff. What you want to give away? A bag of feed, 380-7505. 380-7505 for a bag of feed. Bag of feed. Bag of feed.
That's temperament. That's what you call it. Poor temperament. For real. Wiley.
Pull one. Yeah, 380-6361.
See that? Bird's not moving. 380. That's the difference between poor temperament and good temperament.
6361. If you need raffle tickets, if you need more, if you want yours on. Okay.
Great muscle, just a little flat headed.
Let's go.
No. No, man. No, he ain't. Right. Yeah, you in the big
I'm down.
Okay, no, 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 no.
First, second, third.
Enough said. One of the things, just looking at these two birds, little recessive red spangle of a hen, and this is a cockbird. That cockbird is going to fill out the hen very typey. Keep in mind, the youngsters, they're going to follow this hen's type. So you're going to be able to produce some really nice kid birds. I'm going to start it off at $30 bid. 30, can I get a 40? 40 right here. 50, got 50, can I get a 60? 60, can I get a 70? 70 right here. 70, 80. 80, can I get a 90? 80, can I get a 90? 80. 100, got $100 bid at the back. 110 right there, can I get 120? 110, can I get 120? 120, can I get 120? 120 in front. 120 going once. 120 going twice. So, two pairs. Another hen that was very close to this one, but this one beat it out. Another spangle. Condition was just better.
Oh, the red, the other one. Yeah, the one I bred.
Yeah. Oh, that was the one you bred?
Yes.
Okay. The only thing that beat this one out was condition, and I switched it back. Condition. Other than that, those birds are so close.
She's sitting in the breeder's loft.
Yeah. Yeah, but
them birds don't move too much.
The bird has a great eye on it too, though. Yours?
Yeah.
Really, really good eye on it. Solid, clean, crystal clear, perfect center. Very good bird.
Yeah, I just know the way I peeked it out.
Hey, Sam, right. You know, those three right there. Just hold them.
Yeah, but that one, when it was down at the bottom, I was like, that one has the muscle.
Oh, yeah.
And then the way it stood up, it was standing up like, yeah.
Mm-hmm, like I'm here. Look at me.
Who done called y'all out about this?
All right, do we have any birds left in the month class? All right, let's check them out.
I guess I don't have to pick a first, second, and third, right? Because if it's first, second, do you have first, second, and third?
Yeah, right.
Well, it's easy. Well, then,
yeah. Three, yeah. The cock is the one too, same thing. There's only two cocks though.
I'm gonna do a test
club.
That guy is up.
But these hens are cocks. They mix the hens are cocks.
No, these are all hens. Okay. Three hens and two cocks.
First, second, third.
I was saying, first, third.
Yeah. Make sure you get the
hens. Okay, I could.
All
right, we got first, second, third in the muff class. First, second, third, come get your birds. First, second, and third. Now for the muff cock class. First, second, and third.
Bring I got both of them, so. I've been working on this for quite some time. And
for a cock, he's a little small to me.
Right. It's well working. It's well working.
His type
thank
is
you,
right.
Ray Vaughn. Thank you, Steve Smith. And that's the truth.
First, second. All three, clean sweep. Young Hen, third base, Young Hen. Young Hen, second place. Young Hen, first place. Old Cock, third place. Old Cock. Old Cock, second place. Spin. Old Cock, first place. CSRA. Old Hen, third place. Dre, old hen, third place, Dre. Old hen, second place, CSRA. Old hen, first place. Stan, way to go. Muff cock, third place. Who was it, two? Ali, first and second. Muff, yeah. No third, right? It was no third. Second on the muff hen? What about third on the muff
hen? First was on my belly here.
Third muff hen? First place muff hen?
This
one. Okay, reserve champion, $50 reserve champ. $50 reserve champ.
That's you. Okay.
Juan, $50 reserve champ.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Reserve champ. How much is that? $50. Congratulations. Grand champion, $100 grand champion. There you go, $100 grand champ.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations, Larry.
All right.
All right, we're gonna do this last kickbox. Anybody need any more kickbox tickets? We're gonna raffle off the last kickbox. White ticket. DJ B's, where you at? After I do this one, we're gonna get a little music.
So for Roman Pigeon Evolution, I gotta come and ask you a question. How does it feel?
Oh.
A couple of trophies. A couple, huh?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Reserve champion.
What's your name, brother?
Juan Maldonado.
All right, Juan, what city are you from?
Bakersfield.
All right.
Get that box up.